doing here? Oh my god, it's raining outside. Come on in. Come on in. You can sit down there. You're like soaking. Okay, there you go. I give you some towel. Yeah, your hair is all like wet or something. Oh my goodness. It's like a thunderstorm outside. Okay. It's really, really... It's like raining everywhere. Every day today. Every day. Have you been outside yesterday too? It's been gray. It's like a rainy week or something. I'd like to see the sun, right? Right. Okay, so what do you hear? What happened? I could pretend you know, I've seen the Facebook and stuff. So you broke up with him, right? Oh. Anyways, right. I knew that he was kind of like a jerk to you, you know? I mean, I think it's a good thing, you know? It's a great thing. For you. You can have a great life. I don't know, you know, your life could turn out to be something much better. Right? Yeah, so, because he was treating you quite bad, actually. I really didn't want to be meddled in it or anything like that, but honestly, I didn't really like him much. I'm quite glad that he's out of out of your life and also mine, because kind of driving me nuts, because I think, you know, breakups are hard, but after this, one thing you have to do is find yourself first and, you know, begin to, because you've been dating for so long time, you know, it's always like this. First you break up and you've always been a couple, and then your identity is kind of lost after a while, and then you look for yourself, you find yourself again, and you love yourself a lot more than you loved him. Right? So then you just tend to heal, and after a while, you know, it start to hurt less and less, and you become more stronger and stronger, and you realize that you have a lot more people in your life than you realized before. Yeah, right? Your friends, your family. I am. Right? Okay. Anyways, what we can do right now is to just take care of you. How about this? Okay. I suggest, after this whole horrible rain is gone, let's go for a girls' night today. How about that? I've been like dying to drag you out, but you know, you were like, oh, I'm not sure. I don't know, you know, you were trying to wait, you were asking him like if he can go out today. I mean, I know the couples are supposed to ask each other, but then it was just kind of drag, you know. Now you don't have that excuse. That's the first step, is to just let it all go, relax with me, your friend, right? So now, I think let's do something about your hair, right? And it's okay, you're not prepared, but it's okay. You and me, we both have like the same size clothes, so you can borrow some of my clothes. Like, I have some cool dress that I bought like a month ago. I didn't show you yet. And we didn't have a lot of time to hang out, did we? My God, right? So now I have like this amazing dress. It would look amazing on your rockin' body. I mean, you look hot, right? Okay, let's go out on a hot girls' night out. All right, let's do something about your hair. We're going to comb your hair. We'll just let it naturally dry, and then we could do something like, okay, I'm going to roll it up. And I'm gonna roll it up, and then we're going to like put it in a really nice rolls everywhere, and then leave it on for a while, right? You just relax, okay? You relax. You had a very tough week. I was like, I was wondering when you were coming to talk to me about it. I didn't want to be so persistent. I didn't know what was going on, but the Facebook message was pretty clear. And I get some dry towel. Oh my goodness. Just clear it up. So, anyways, I mean, we have to plug your eyebrows. Right. I know. It's been a tough week. I can see. I can figure it out for you. I can help you. Anyways, it's gonna be a bit painful, but you know, once you plug your eyebrows and shape them nicely, cut some hair, cut the eyebrow hair, and just make it look awesome. You could be looking like an amazing queen after this. Okay. Now that you're pretty much kind of dry, okay, let me just get some. So, how did it all go down to? You just, after a while, you couldn't take it, right? Yeah. Well, it's okay. I mean, sometimes you just know, you know, when you're in a relationship, you just know that it's not meant to be, and you just realize like, oh my goodness. But you were right in the nick of time too. I mean, you know, you don't want to waste your time for so long time with him, right? Exactly. I mean, you're a gorgeous person, right? I mean, you're an amazing human being. And I know you deserve better than him. And, you know, maybe he's just not meant to be. Maybe he was a good person. I don't know. Maybe you two are just meant to be their separate ways. That's the kind of like an adult way to look at it, I guess, right? Move on to better fish. There are so many better fishes. Like, okay, so now let me put your hair up on a roll. My rolls are my rolls. There you go. Okay. Section those up. I've been like doing so many things. I didn't really relax much recently. I finished my exams. Everything's going well. I've watched this new movie recently. Yeah, it's the new Star Wars movie, and oh my god, it was amazing. Well, we can watch it together again. I don't mind, cause oh my goodness, it was so good. I won't tell you anything about it. Don't ask me. Get some rope. We're gonna have to roll it up in a very tight, smaller roll so that I can put it up in the very curly kind of, you know, make it look really gorgeous. Right. Hair is looking all right. Wait, let me get this. Oh, come on. I don't know where I've heard it. It's like stuck to my. I've been listening to Ariana Grande. Yeah, that's amazing. I know I haven't been listening to that, but recently I just I've been listening to that new album of Ariana Grande's, and it's pretty nice. Very, very, very nice. Oh yeah, this new song. Oh, it's not really new, is it? It's like 1 year old. I'm so behind these days. That one is called Bad Decisions. It was very nice. Boy, you're making me bad decisions. So I've got this amazing dress that I'm going to show you, and I did make some alterations on it because, you know, the normal size, I made it a bit, put some drafts on the sides, you know, like make it really fit the body, right? So make it really looks gorgeous, really, honestly amazing. So that's the dress is like it's more like those, what do you call that, body tight, body knit dress, yeah, but it's not really tight, really. It's kind of sparkly, but it's black, so it's midnight sparkly kind of thing, you know. And we can go for a very nice smoky eye look. I think I'm gonna wear a pants today, like a skinny jeans, very nice. Loose top. I have this nice loose top and skinny jeans, stilettos. You can decide if you want the wedges or the just the stilettos. If we're going off a girls' night, you know, you probably prefer the wedges because stilettos kind of hard to walk. Mm-hmm. is like the moonlight. Is it moonlight or moonlight? Yes. Is it not too tight? Is that your hair? I don't really like the girls' night out itself, really. What I really like about is the preparation, the amount of work, and the talk, the girly talk, and the makeups and all those preparations make. And wait, where is my hair? Pin, 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 pin. Oh, there it is. Go. Few more and we're done with the hair. Oh, got a pin. There I go. Just leave your hair in a curl. It's gonna take a while to set. I don't want to use any hairspray or anything because it's not gonna be good because hairspray is not good for your hair. Anyways, if I use a lot of hairspray, it will be like crispy kind of thing. After we take out the hair curls, we are going to just comb it up a little bit and then put some hair mousse. Then it's much more subtle. Now, let's do something about your eyebrows. I have this set of things. Oh, it makes me look like I'm a professional at what I do. Just kidding. Okay. And just stand still, don't move around. I'm going to plug your eyebrows. It's a little bit wild, actually. Around your eye, on top of the eyebrow, and in the middle of the eyebrows. I just have to use this tool. I know it's gonna hurt because you've not been plugging it for a while, but it's okay. It's the guarantee. I guarantee you'll feel so good. Okay, close your eyes. Okay, don't think about anything at all. Just relax. After this, I have to apply mine too, because oh my gosh. Well, let's talk about something else. How are things? How's your family? Miss your mom too. Because she. I miss her cooking also. Oh, the pie. Oh my goodness. It's the best apple pie ever. In my life, honestly. Just tilt your head a bit. Yes. Don't move, it's gonna hurt a little bit, but okay. Under your eyebrow, just a bit, okay? Just a bit. It came out with the roots. So it's gonna be a while for it to regrow again. So it's worth it. On top of your eyebrow, just a bit. Because it is a lot, really. Yeah. I mean, considering me, you have less brow hair to be thinking about, because mine, oh my gosh, if I let it go, like, I of course I did let it go and didn't even plug it for like 2 weeks, and I looked like the Planet of the Apes. The apes. Caesar, the Planet of the Apes. I really did look like that, honestly. And you don't recognize it, you don't see it, and you don't realize it until you just take a small little mirror that's for the, you know, the eyebrow mirror with the little brush and the eyebrow kit. Then you open it up outside in public to just look at, like, which part that I should you know, redraw or something. My eyebrows, is it looking good or something? But then you realize your eyebrows actually like crazy, but you can't start plugging because you didn't bring your little the eyebrow plugger device thing, scissors, whatever you call it. I forget. So on the other side, this side is completely done, and we go to the other side. Okay, so then it's just crazy, my eyebrows crazy. Then you just realize, oh my gosh, Planet of the Apes staring back at me. How do I get rid of that? So that was the last time I had to like take out that, go home, plug my eyebrows next day, because at night I don't want to plug it. It's so tired. Yours is actually easier to plug. I don't know why, because mine is like the roots are just really big and very stubborn. I don't use wax on my eyebrow. I'm not good with wax. And especially if it's hair on the face, you never know what you're gonna pluck. Accidentally, you're like, oh, strip. What if it's your eyelashes? Some hairs, yeah. It's very dangerous. Last time when I was a kid, did I tell you this story? No, I didn't, right? When I was a kid, I think it was 10 or 11. Yeah. Like, everybody's starting to fix their eyebrows or something, and I looked at myself, and I thought, like, because, you know, Planet of the Apes. I looked at myself, and I thought, like, well, I went to fix my eyebrows. Not then, the only time I've seen anybody pluck or get rid of hair on the face is my dad using the shaver with the foam and things, so never a good idea. So I put some shaver cream on my eyebrow, on the bottom of it, right, because it's huge shaver cream, so I put it on the bottom of it. Then I have the shaver, his shaver, and I
gently shave it away, scrape it away. Oh my gosh, I never recovered from that. And the next day I had to, it was Sunday anyways, I had to go to school on Monday. And it was painful. I had to draw my eyebrows, but I didn't have eyebrow pencils, and I didn't tell my parents because I was a foolish little girl. Then I it was uneven eyebrows too, so I got some other pencil. Yes, I got a hold of the mascara that my mom was about to throw, so I took it and I put it on my eyebrow, which was a very bad idea, you know, and it looked really stupid. Anyways, you're done. Easy. So now I'm going to cut away just a bit of the eyebrow hairs. You don't want to cut a lot, you know, because I usually cut a lot for mine. But anyways, my hair grows very fast. My eyebrows grows so fast, I can't catch up with it. Sometimes I cut a lot. And unfortunately, some areas I cut like too much, and some areas I didn't. So there's a little bald patch on my eyebrow sometimes. Anyways, but then I put just the eyebrow kit, just dry it, fill it up, and nobody notices. And just like 2 days later, it's all covered with real eyebrow hair. Okay, now we're done with the eyebrow, and your hair, your face is looking amazing, amazing, great. Gorgeous. Okay, now we're going to look at. Okay, so now I'm going to put. First, I'm going to put face conditioning cream. And it has SPF 25 in it. But let me tell you, even though we're going out at night, and there's no sunlight, we can use this cream because I stand by this cream. Ever since I found this and I put it on my face, even though I didn't put any makeup on, I just put this and I go out. I look amazing. It redefines the pores and yeah, makes you look really. It really conditions your face, honestly. So all the red patches and stuff will go away, kinda, just a bit, really. It's not really perfectly. It doesn't even have a color, so it's just a creamy, really, very light. So I'm gonna take it up. And it smells so cute. Very smells good. Okay. Wait. Just all over your face. Just a little light bit of cream on your face. It's done. Okay, now what we're going to do, is let me get my
So next we'll put Urban Decay's Optical Illusion Complexion Primer. This is perfect. It's perfect for smoothing your face, and it's pore perfecting in the best sense of the word. After you put it on, it's just amazing for the makeup. You know, I think it really helps for the setting of the powder, setting of the liquid foundations. It doesn't smell good, but honest man, it's amazing. And it costs a lot, but it was a great investment because you see my face has a lot of pores, so, and it's like a very tiny little amount, but yeah, it will last a lot. I don't make up a lot. Okay, let's put some, but it makes your face look, you know, this one coming with the other one is just heavenly, amazing. Just put it all over your face. I know it doesn't feel good, but just let it set. It's done now. Let's put it back. And we have false eyelashes. Yes, we do want it. We do. Okay. Now. Okay. Let me put this back. Face condition. Cream. Okay, wait. While your powder, your primer is being set, what I'm going to do for myself is a little mask. I'll put on some mask, okay? It's that Innisfree cream mask thing. It's like a, what do you call that? Let me see. Jeju Volcanic Color Clay Mask. It's a clay mask. I have some. My face is just needing some kind of a hydration and some kind of a loving, you know, TLC. I've not been taking care of it for the last 1 month. After this, I'm going to prepare myself too, but first let's focus on you first. Let you have some amazing makeup for that. You have to set the powder, set the, you know, everything takes time. Amazing makeup takes time. Yeah. Yeah, and this mask is so good that feels good. It's going to be perfect for the evening. I'm done. I'm mostly done. I look like a crazy person, but it's okay. Alright. Now. Okay. Your primer is set. We're going to put in some liquid. Wait, where is it? The liquid foundation. Let me get some. All stuck there. It's a very nice liquid foundation. Pump it. And now I have this excuse me. I have the little sponge. I bought it at a good price online, because I'm not gonna buy the $38 worth of sponge that looks like a teardrop, but I'm gonna pay $2 for the similar thing and same color. I've gone ahead and made it a little bit wet so that it won't take away all of the, and I mean it won't suck in all of the liquid foundation that I have here. And we're going to put it on your face, just all over your face. Isn't it nice to have like a preparation like this? It's like relaxing, really. I like this sponge. It's kind of tough. It's not actually. It's not like a sponge kind of. You know, it's much tougher than what I thought. Usually, I thought this kind of sponge would be those old makeup sponges. You know, so soft, and I never really like them. But this is quite good. And it has little sharp edge where you can go into corners and stuff. Close your eyes. Let me just put some liquid foundation on your eyes too. Just everywhere. Okay. Let's let it dry. Let me, there's too much foundation here, let me take it out. Okay. Now, wait, let me put it back. That's my thing. I never put back things where I got it from. Wait, these two has to go back. Now, while it's setting, let's do the eyebrows. No, I have to do the powders first. Do the powder first and let's set it first, and then after that we just do the eyes, meaning the eyeshadows first, all the things, then we take away the setting powder and we do the contour and stuff. Okay, now we have pressed powder that is setting powder. And I'm gonna use a brush, I don't care. I have a powder brush. And now I'm just going to do this. Okay. Just pile it all on face, on the top. Part of it, your V, the T shape or whichever. I'm just winging it. Okay, don't breathe in this stuff. Let me put it back. Okay. Okay, now you look like a crazy person just like me, so it's good. Alright. So now what I'm gonna do is the actual eyeshadow. Eyeshadow makeup. I have the perfect palette. Eyeshadow palette. It's from Icon. Looks like and feels like the Urban Decay palette. Naked palettes, but it's just different name. And maybe it's not as good, but I really don't care. It has a cute brush inside, two edges of the brush. Let me get it. There's the blending part of the brush, and there's this stiffer part where you apply the shadows, eyeshadows on. Thor. Yikes. Now I have this eyeshadow base. We have to put it first. Okay. Close your eye. Okay. The other side, yeah. All over, really. Okay. Now, let's choose the color. I want to look for a very nice, very nice smoky eye. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm not going to choose completely black color, because really I do have black color on this. Your dress will be black, very nice, tight, shiny little black dress I have. That's good, great, but that if I use black, you really would look like a witch or something. So I'm going to choose something that's very nice. Equally dark in shade, but it will look gorgeous. Yeah, okay. So I'm gonna get this brownish, blackish color, and it has little purple, glittery kind of feel to it. It's called Java, like a Java coffee kind of color, but oh my goodness, it is gorgeous. Okay, I got the stiff part of the brush. I'm going to put a lot of it because we're going to do the smoky eye effect. Okay, so close your eyes. Get some more, and we're just gonna put like an almond shape. We're not particular at this moment because we're gonna smoke it out, and we're gonna add on the other eye. Wait. Close your eyes. The other side. Yep. And we're gonna pile it up. And wow, it's a beautiful color for you. Okay, we're going to use that blending edge. We're going to gently blend upward from back to forward. The other side, just blend a bit more. I'm going to use it on the other side, the stiff side of the brush. And we're going to add on, make it better, and then blend it. The other side, blend it. Blend, and I see a few more applications are needed. Just blend it, and the other side. I just want it to be perfect. Perfect looking, you know, like perfectly blended. Okay. And I'm still going to use the shadows just a little bit more. I'm going to get the chocolate eye pencil. And it's a brown shape. It's quite similar to the shape of the shade of the Java, but I'm going to align your eye. Close your eyes, yeah. The other side, it just glides on your eyelashes so smoothly. It's like buttery, you know. Okay, it may come off, that's why I'm going to use the stiff edge of the brush, dip it onto the same Java ink. We don't want too much. And close your eyes. I'm going to just put it, just dab it on top of that chocolatey eyeliner pencil, because that way, the other side, your eyes eyeliner will not fade away. It will be more resistant. Now I want to highlight the eyebrow bone shape and your teardrop area, the middle of it, and then I will use this ballet pink color, but it's not pink really. It's going to look beautiful highlighted. I'm just going to use my hand for this because it's just as get more. And the other side, just do your brow, the front bit. Okay, and we're done with the eyeshadow. Let me put this here. Now, okay, I need this brush, powder brush, crazy brush. Okay, close your eyes. I'm going to just take off the setting powder and then distribute it to everywhere else, just like this. This is why I didn't make up your eyebrows. I mean, because the powder will be blowing up everywhere. Look up. I'm going to go over your neck also, because and your ears. Just a bit. You know. Now I'm going to take away some of the powders from my eyebrows. Now that I've brushed your eyebrows, I'm going to get my perfect eyebrow pencil, the sharp edge, and I'm going to get my eyebrow kit. This is perfect for your eyebrow. There's a gel end and there's a powder end. We're going to start with the gel. It's perfect for your eyebrow
put the gel first so that you're going to get the effect that you want, the ends of the eyebrow. It's gonna be smooth, it's gonna be perfect. It's going to be gorgeous, sharp eyebrow. And now I'm going to get another brush, and I'm going to use this for the powder edge so that we won't have these sharp angles and sharp edges. The sun, and it makes your eyebrow look gorgeous. Amazing. We put it back. Okay. Now eyebrows done. Shadows all done. Everything's great. Let me get the powder from eyeshadows. Just fell some here. Okay. Clean face. Clean everything. Now I want to do the. Do the blusher. I want to do the contour. I want to do the bronzing right now. I have a powder bronzer. I'm sorry. I have a powder contour and I have a contour brush. I'm going to get the powder contour. Just contour. You have amazing cheekbones. Then just shape it. I know, I mean these contours and bronzers and highlighters, all these are so expensive. One time I accidentally dropped my eyebrow kit. The one with the gel and the powder. Cost me pretty much, like so much. I was so sad and angry at myself. Ruined my whole day. And it was very hard to find it anyways. It wasn't selling here, so I had to go to the internet, buy it, wait for like 2 months for it to arrive. Anyways, now contouring is done. We're going to get another big brush. We're going to get some bronzer powder. I have this perfect little palette from the Urban Decay bronzer, highlighter, and a blusher all together. So I'm going to get some bronzer. I really like the sun-kissed tan kind of look, just a little bit of tan. You don't want it too much. Anything of too much is like too overwhelming, not good. Alright, now I need this brush. I have this cute little cottontail. Cute looking brush for the blusher. It really looks like a rabbit's tail kind of look. Cute. It's all of them are synthetic anyways, but it looks cute. Okay, I have this cute, gorgeous looking blusher in the shade of, and she doesn't say. Well, it's pink in shade, but it has the peachy like tint to it. Together it goes perfectly well with the bronzer that I just put. So anyway, we're going to blend it out, just like do this for me, like smile. Yeah. Oh, there you go, you have so gorgeous cheekbones. There you go, the other side. Yay, smile. Let me get some. Amazing.
highlight. I've never used this brush before, so I'm going to use it as highlighter brush. Highlighters these days are the bomb. Okay, I'm gonna get some highlighter, and this highlighter is not a Fenty. Yeah, it's not from Rihanna, but it's from Urban Decay, and it's amazing. Okay, I'm going to highlight. Just go like this, and it looks gorgeous on your face, of course. And then on your little bit on top of your nose, just a bit on the sides again. Okay, on your chin, one little drop of chin. Okay, just a bit. It highlights, you know, it makes you look so good, gorgeous. Okay, now I haven't done your eyelashes. Which mascara should I use? Okay, I'm gonna use this one. Waterproof. It's hard to take it off, but it's better. Okay, I'm going to put on the false eyelashes first. Oh my goodness. Is this ever gonna end? Okay, anyways. I'm going to get this. Wait a second. Where did I put the? Oh, there it is. I have the glue. Okay, it's hard work. You have to like shake it and blow it until it's tacky enough, like sticky enough, then you can put it on your eyelashes, just on top of your eyelashes. Okay, so close your eyes. I think it works. Another one. You have to wait quite a while, actually. Okay. At first, you have to put it, just angle it towards the one side, and then you push it to the middle and the other side, just direct it, and then once it's set, it's perfect. Okay, now I'm going to use the eyelash curler. Okay, just be careful. Hold it a bit, and the other side. Okay. We're almost there. And mascara. You have to get the mascara in both of your eyelash and your false eyelashes together. That's like the bonding for you. And where's my... Okay. All right. Okay, now you look amazing. It looks gorgeous. And... She's done. Now I'm going to go for the Okay, so now I have this L'Oreal's infallible 6 hours lip liner. I'm sorry, it's in the shade of nude. So I'm just gonna line your lips just a bit bigger than make it look beautiful, plush. Not too much though. Yeah. Then I'm going to, you know, I'm going to get this gorgeous lipstick, potpourri lipstick. It's a medium rose color. Gorgeous. Okay. Do you smell it? It's like vanilla smell. Gorgeous smell. I'm collecting kind of like a lipstick collection kind of thing. I'm like so interested in do this. Yeah, it's perfect because it matches the lip liner. So I'm done with the lipstick though, but I'm so interested in collecting, and I'm so interested in lipsticks these days. Jeez, man. Stop raining, please. Okay, now we have the lips done. Oh my goodness, you look amazing. Okay, except for the fact that your hair is like crazy. Let's do your hair now. I know it's been just a while, but we take it out. Let's see what happens. My work here is done. Okay, you look gorgeous. And now it's my turn. So I have to go and wash my face with this mask. And I'm going to do my hair and do my makeup. And I'm going to get ready to go out for the girls' night fun. A girls' night fun. I'll be back.